Geoffrey, let's kick it off with you. What did you learn from the Fed? Growth is okay, but inflation they can't really quite figure out yet.
And I really think that the markets have sort of steeled themselves, for a slightly stronger message on inflation, just in the same way the market was steeling themselves for stronger print for the January CPI numbers, but, just manage the weather things okay. I think up ahead, it's are we, again, going to see that transmission from potential wage growth into inflation, higher spending and higher investment? That escape velocity, that lift, it just seems like the Fed isn't there yet.
Kallum?
When it comes to monetary policy in the US, it is still too easy relative to economic conditions, expectations for growth and inflation. All the Fed seems to be doing for now, rather than looking to put the brakes on the economy, is simply rubber stamp the higher growth, higher inflation expectations. So if we get 4 hikes instead of 3 this year, it will make very little difference for the economic environment.
Geoffrey, you from your space in foreign exchange, the litmus paper of the system, as you look at bonds, is this movement up in yields, is it linear or quadratic effect on the other markets? Does it build up with a certain momentum and boom, it hits at a point, or is it just a linear grind up?
I think for now, people are happy with the linear grind up, to be honest. If the dollar strengthens, for the rest of the world, that's treated more as a stimulus more than anything. If I look at euro dollar right now, I think there's a bit more action on the euro leg, how defensive positioning is heading into some event risk that we have in Europe. But for now, on the dollar side, a lot of it's priced in. So probably there's going to be a lack of upward momentum just solely focused on the Fed alone.
Kallum, do we just focus this in on the fiscal policy of the United States of America? I've got an op-ed, a morning must read, with Kevin Cirilli in the next hour. Is this just about a buildup in debt?
No, this is a return to normal. If I take a kind of a rule of thumb, I would look at nominal GDP growth as my benchmark for where long-term yields should be. They roughly measure the same thing. Nominal GDP is well above long-term yield. So all I'm seeing now is an exit out of the age of caution, the excess saving, into a normalization where yields simply go back to the levels consistent with normal economic momentum.